Hello, this is Alex Gorzen from Liquid Web with our video on exporting databases and tables with PhpMyAdmin. Exporting databases through PhpMyAdmin is an easy yet powerful tool that can save you a lot of time and headaches. It is a simple way to make a backup of your data, so exporting a table before you make a big change can help undo any mistakes and avoid data loss. PhpMyAdmin can also export into different formats, which may be useful for plugging those files into different applications or for accounting purposes. Exporting also helps with quickly moving databases from one server to another using only your browser. I am logged into PhpMyAdmin on my test server here, and I have a WordPress database I copied from a live site. We can start with showing the different types of exports that we can do. First, on the main PhpMyAdmin page here, we can go to Export, and it says Exporting Databases from the Current Server. This means it will export all databases the user has access to into a single file. This is best if we are manually making a backup and want to make sure we get everything, but having one large file can make it harder to get to a specific database or table. So now, if we click on the database name and go to the Export tab there, it says exporting tables from the LWTest database, so that would be the tables within a single database. Then if we just want a single table, click on the table name from the navigation menu on the left, click on the export tab, and now it says exporting rows from the WP comments table. Let's quickly jump back to the database itself to get a whole database backup. The page starts with mentioning templates, which if we are exporting something regularly, we can create a template and go through these custom settings and choose which tables we want it to save, how the file name is formatted, what goes into the exported file, and many other more advanced settings that can be used if needed. We don't have to create a template, and we can just stick with the quick export so that at least makes sure that we have all tables and records currently in the database. Then, we can choose the format the database will be exported to. If we are going from one database server to another, or just saving a backup copy, the SQL format would generally be the best option for that. But if the data was going to some other sort of application, we might want to choose a spreadsheet, PDF, XML, or a CSV file. We will stay with SQL for now, then click on the Go button, and it starts the download. Depending on the size of the database, this could take a few seconds or a few minutes, but this database is only 48 megabytes in SQL format and is now saved to my local computer. It can be stored as a backup, uploaded to a different server, or even sent to someone else so they can have their own copy that they can work with. That's all for this video on exporting databases and tables with PhpMyAdmin. For more how-tos and tutorials, visit our knowledge base at liquidweb.com/kb or our YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you for watching!